Now, the interrupts. I have here a few slides about the interrupts, how the interrupt works. Okay, we're running usually in the main, in some main process, mainly in the main while one loop, in the file main.c. When the STM32 periphery detects the interrupt and we configure the periphery to create the interrupt, we send the interrupt event to the NVIC. In case that in the NVIC is the interrupt enabled, NVIC will notify the core. The core stops the processing of the main process and goes into the interrupt handler. When the interrupt handler ends, and also when in the interrupt handler we clear all the events, the microcontroller return back into the main process. This is the purpose of the interrupt, to handle the asynchronous events during the execution of the main program. Yes, for this the interrupts, we can have the multiple interrupts, and we need to decide which interrupts have the priority. What is for us the interrupt with the highest priority? Then for this, the NVIC has the embedded arbiter, which we saw before. When if we have one interrupt, we doing the one interrupt, and we trigger the second interrupt, which have the higher priority or lower priority. This interrupt with the higher priority can be executing before the low priority interrupt, and then we turn to the low priority interrupt and back to main process. This called the preemption priority. Preemption means that the interrupt with the higher priority can stop the interrupt with the lower priority and execute himself. The sub priority is something different. In case that we have the two interrupts with the same group priority, same preemption priority, but they have different sub priority. In case that the IRQ1 came first, then came the IRQ2, the core doesn't matter, because the preemption priority is the same. We wait after the interrupt 1 execution ends, and then we start executing the interrupt 2 with the same preemption priority. But in case that these two interrupts came in the same time, then now the sub priority it's take his role, and the interrupt with the lower sub priority will be executed first. In this case is the IRQ1, and after IRQ1 will end, we continue with the IRQ2. Then the sub priority it's only take cares when the interrupts came in the same time. In the core, you can choose with the group priority how many bits are reserved for the preemption priority and the sub priority. This is available only on the M3 and the M4 cores. On the M0 and M0 plus, this function is not available. You have only preemption priority. But on our M3, M4 and also M7 cores, we have this possibility to select how many bits, because for the priority groups you have only the 4 bits, then you can have priority for 0 to 16, but you can select how many bits I use for the preemption priorities and or the sub priorities. Yes, during the enabling the interrupts in the NVIC, you maybe saw that there is put the strange name with the IRQ type. Which interrupt is it? this usual number, and this number is defined in the STM32F4X6.h, but usually QPMX do this for you. But in case that you want to enable the interrupt in the HAL underscore NVIC underscore set priority on your own, you need to have the name of this interrupt, and this name is defined in the STM32F4X6.h.